In this video, we are going to discuss about the secondary memory. In the previous video, we discussed about the primary memory, which was very fast, but at the same time, it was very expensive as well as volatile. So, a cheaper memory was needed, which could be had in very large amount, so that big programs or instructions, even large amount of data could be stored. This was possible due to the secondary memory. Now let's see what a secondary memory is and what are its characteristics. It is non-volatile. That means if I switch off the computer, the data will not be erased. The data and instructions will still remain on the secondary memory. It has large capacities to the tune of terabytes. As we discussed in the previous video, RAMs maximum they have 1 GB or 2 GB of memory space. However, for secondary memory, we can have terabytes of memory. It is cheaper as compared to the primary memory. Why? Because it is slower. There are two types of secondary memory, fixed and removable. The fixed memory or the fixed secondary memory is part of the CPU, the central processing unit, whereas the removable secondary memory can be attached and removed at will. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the different types of secondary memory.